it's Sturgeon Steve. I'm just down here in the San Francisco Bay looking for invertebrates and gravid females. Well, hey there, Delta Smell Derek. How are you?
Oh, just swell, Sturgeon Steve. The only thing is, it seems there's been less and less outflow of fresh water these days. Hey, have you seen any of my Osmeridae family?
No. I hardly see any of you guys around here anymore.
Yeah, it seemed just the other day I was out here with everybody.
Yeah, I can remember them days.
Those were the good old days. Hey, what's that?
No, Delta Smell Derek, those are the pumps! Oh no. Well, looks like it's another casualty of the entrainment of the pumps. Can't let it go to waste.
Between the third and fourth row of the mothball fleet located in Martinez, California, I believe.
Yeah. My name is George from Bay Tackle, El Cerrito.
California faces a chronic shortage of water. How do you feel this will affect the sport fisheries of the bay?
Well, they draw too much water off the rivers, you know, water runs to the south, and the farmers demands more water for plantation, but also it's bad for the fish, you know. Water temperature is warming up when the water level is low in the rivers and doesn't give the proper right temperature for the salmon to spawn. End up killing more salmon eggs. End up having less fish. That's right. Right now they're talking about salmon closure in the ocean, so potentially no salmon fishermen out there.
How have the oil spill and the sewage spills into the bay affected sport fishing, in your opinion?
Well, that's another bad news. You know, when the oil spill, it kills some of the birds, which is a long-term damage to the fishing habitats. And also scared most of us sport fishermen, you know, they want to eat oil fish. And we end up lost more business.
Yeah. You know? Do you eat the fish that you catch in the bay?
I ate them too, you know.
Compared to historically, maybe?
Yeah. Fish is still healthy, you know. We might have a mercury. They always say there's a mercury in there, but I think the fish overall is still healthy.
Yes, I do. I believe it's safe as any other kind of meat you buy in the store. Chicken, beef, organic, everything's dangerous nowadays. The state of California is dangerous.
I just eat what I catch.
Catching more fish in the South Bay since the oil spill? You kind of saw a trend that way?
Yeah, we can't say exactly like how many number is caught in the South Bay, but it seems like our local fishermen that went out fishing in the South Bay and had the limits of the sturgeons and other fishes. You know, in the wintertime, at least in the last few months, we caught a lot of sturgeons out of South Bay out there. It's not that like the oil has killed them.
Maybe they moved to other areas to avoid the contamination.
That's right. But you know, our system in the bait is with the incoming tide and outgoing tide.
Right. It flushes pretty good.
It flushes pretty good. It's a huge quantity of water, you know, moving through. 58,000 gallons sounds like a big number, but it's spread out, you know, not much.
How about the mothball fleet? Have they been doing well there for sturgeon?
Mm-hmm. Mothball fleet has always been an excellent spot for sturgeon fishing.
Well-known sturgeon hole and many large-sized sturgeon are caught here year-round.
How long have you been coming out here to fish at the mothball fleet?
Oh, years. I've only caught a couple, I'm not gonna lie.
Have you been following the news how they're talking about moving those boats out of the area to Texas to be...
Yeah,
the paint is chipping off. There's like 20 tons of hazardous materials that's falling off them.
You knew where we're at? These ships might not be here for that long. They're trying to get rid of them. They are causing pollution.
whenever you move those ships, you probably stirred up those mercuries and everything too.
Yeah.
So, you know, those ships, I have a no comment.
Like the asbestos in your ceiling.
Yeah.
It's all right to be there until you start scraping it off.
Right.
Well, if they think about pollution, you think that moving into another spot will solve the problem, or just pollute it in another spot?
You gotta move it and destroy it and make it steel out of it again.
Do you feel more safe eating fish 10 years ago than you would today?
Well, I don't know about that. That's a hard question, because 10 years ago seems like a long time, but they were doing a lot more illegal activities, or legal at the time activities, dumping certain chemicals or whatever in the bay. Could range from drugs, you know, anything.
Contaminants of any sort.
Yeah, Lysol, agricultural runoff, that's not a good thing, you know, it's fertilizer. Throw fertilizer in the water, it can't be good for the fish.
See, the state's not running things right.
No.
Management, just like people building the freeways, they don't have a driver's license and you have an off-ramp so close to an on-ramp. And they don't know what the system's wrong. The whole system's wrong.
It need to have a proper management, the water management,
right?
You know.
Okay.
They need to have a more water storage to store more water. So during the summer months, they don't have to draw so much water off the rivers to send water to the south. It costs money, but you know what? Our population keep going up. Our water consumption is going up.
Yeah.
And we can't ask the Scotlands give us a ring in the summer in California.